Okay, today I'm going to be showing you how to replace a turbo on a 2009 to 2012 Audi A4 2.0T. It's a 2.0T FSI engine. This model has the K03 turbo. This is what we're going to be removing. We gotta remove this front panel in order to get to this intake duct, and then from there we gotta get the actual intake filter out in the tube. And then down there, diverter valve spacer is gonna come out. I'm going to be showing y'all exactly what to do. Alright guys, so here you have four T30s. It's T30. Just slides out forward. Okay. Here we have two, looks like T25. So you have two T25s that have to come out for the intake duct. Just pops off. Put that somewhere safe. The screws. And then this guy, there's a 7mm here, and a 7mm down there where the inlet is, okay? You gotta take those off. Moving on, we gotta take out, okay, just this guy here, and we got a 7 at the moment. I just don't want to waste my time looking for it, so I got a flathead. That guy just pops off like so. Would you look at that? This comes out. You go and take the assembly filter comes out. And then here comes the fun part. We get into the fun part already. So we gotta disconnect that one down there. This guy here. And then we'll remove and continuance. It cut off for some reason. But we'll remove this PVC hose out of the way. And then, here we go. It wasn't too long. It just comes off. Save this. So this is the fun part here. This is where we're getting to, close to the turbo. But before we get to any further, I want to take the oil and drain it out, because I got to do an oil change on this thing anyway. And I want to show you what it looks like when it's been like leaking like crazy. Like here, you can already see that there's oil dripping. Here we have the diverter valve. I'm gonna put a spacer on there, so I'm gonna have to remove that too. And then from there, we'll take this out, which I guess we'll go ahead and do that. And then from there, the turbo is air free. And then you take the lines off the block, remove those lines out of the way. Hope it doesn't make too much oil. And then from there, we should be good to go. Just continue with removing the turbo. So, oh great. At least I get to show y'all. Okay. So that's the diverter valve. We'll have to remove this, right? And it's a 5 millimeter Allen. Here goes one. Okay, now that I got them loose.
Guys.
This man. No got off road though. Guys. This guy. So, and then we have our diverter valve off. I installed the spacer. This is not necessary. I don't think it's necessary. Okay, cool. It's not necessary. Alright, we'll continue. So now we gotta take those lines out, and I think those are triple square, 8 millimeter triple square. I got my 8 millimeter triple square. We're just gonna right there, and then that comes out like so. Top one's right here. This guy, and I think that's 12. I hope it's in a 12. Oh, thank God. It's because I don't have another size up. Comes out loose. You got two washers on this guy. You got one under the line, and one that comes after the see, two washers here, and this is your banjo bolt. This is your banjo bolt. So now that we can wiggle this, oh yeah, we'll go ahead and get our triple square 8 millimeter and take these guys off. We lube that up. I tried taking this guy off, but since I got a triple square that's like this, I need one that's kind of like about to right here somewhere. Take it out, so I'm gonna have to go to store or something, because I can't even fit it like this. I'm kind of using a wrench either, because it hits against the manifold. That sucks. I don't want to strip that. It's the right thing. See this connection here? Be careful, you don't want to break those plastic tabs. That's where it's gonna go back into place. And then you just push on it like that, and then that just comes out. You pull it and you push on it. So you pull it to unlock it, and then you push on it to release the tension of the clip. So Now that we got this disconnected. Alrighty, fellas, we're gonna pull this line out. And this is the oil feed. There's the oil feed. I'm having a hard time to focus. We're gonna have to replace the O-ring for sure. And the washers that go into the turbo are gonna have to be replaced. And then we have our coolant hose here. And we'll have to remove that clamp. So I guess we'll go ahead and do that. A little too big for the job, but as long as it'll get the job done, I just kind of. Now we can not deal with all that. I mean, I know it's an extra step, but if you're not lazy, why not do it? Right? Okay, so, we continue. Plug this back in. I'm just not gonna put the clamp on. Just plug it back in. So then from here, we just gotta disconnect this guy. To disconnect this guy, you kinda just... Yeah. And you just kinda improvise. You're moving it. You gotta do like a puzzle. So then that's out. So we got that out of the way. That's the line that connects to the intake manifold. Okay. So I just disconnected the connection to our, wastegate frequency control valve. And that's this here. I'm gonna show you this connection there. And disconnect it. That's your wastegate frequency control valve. So we carry that situation. And now, oh great, I forgot I had to. Let's see if I can kind of move this out of the way. Shot. Barely fit in there. Like, barely. Here's our gasket, and that's freaking boring. So, now that this is loose, you can just like put this to the side. Guy there, and then after that, I'm going to take these off. because I'm replacing the catalytic converter anyway, and then we should be good. So I broke loose too. See how it like all moves together. Take it out. So you see, now it's at this angle. Before, we take it out though, back here somewhere, there is, no, that's on. Let's disconnect it. Remove it from that clip, right? And come back over here. And now you are ready to remove the catalytic converter. Guys. Alrighty, guys. So far, I got this far. I got the catalytic converter in this position. But as I noticed, there's the wastegate. And guess what? I can spin it. That's crazy, right? The thing is, I ordered a turbo. Wait a second. I'm tripping. The one's on the back, actually. Yeah, that's the cool one. Yeah, the one on the back. Oh, shit. Actually, I think we're good, guys. The turbo's good, fellas. Guess what? Holy fucking shit. Yo way. Yo, that's gonna add horsepower to my fucking car for sure. Yo, what in the nation is that? White and black ass shit. Look, look, it hides the black and then you shave it. No fucking way, bro. Look at that shit. Well, fellas, how do we take it out? We're about to find out. Let's see if... Guys, it worked. Oh my god, it worked. So good. I think they're 12 millimeters. Nuts. because he really did open the mask. See? Mr. Open the mask. There's a bracket underneath that has to be loosened as well. And to show y'all, does this one even have it? This one doesn't have the bracket. What? No way. They didn't even put the bracket, bruh. Yeah. In order to take that out. What happened? So you see this? How is this gonna fit in here? This one. And just kind of do that, and go that, and then jam it in on that one. 13 millimeter. Just kind of go do that. So we got that loose, and then the gasket's definitely blown. We don't need that. We just gotta disconnect it from down here. Move that. Last step would be to remove the cooling line. And then the turbo. So there's the turbo. I didn't have to move that. So we're gonna service this turbo. As you can tell, look, this in comparison to what I thought it was gonna be like, right? That's how you replace a turbo. catalytic converter. Now we got definitely. If you just feel the weight of this really bad gunked up catalytic converter. Oh my god. You can kind of see it. Okay. So pay attention. I just took the bolts off of this wastegate frequency control valve. Okay. So these hoses are going to be disconnected, but for the meantime I think I'm going to replace them because look how rusty they are. This shit's slack. This one here, that was coming to me here with the blow valve. To the bottom connection hose, and then this one, the one that goes out the opposite direction from them, goes to this guy 90 degrees, and then this one here goes to the top one. Just wait for the one I ordered to come in. Take a good peek on how tight this is. So this is where the oil was leaking from, right? Saying this, this is totally fine, it doesn't even move. So I just took that off of this pipe. This pipe was already messed up. I think somebody had replaced this in the junkyard.